The Finsteraarhorn is the highest peak in the Bernese Alps, 4,274 metres, which offers breathtaking views of the surroundings. To conquer it, the road is long. In fact, you have to cross the Jungfraujoch, which is part of the largest glacier in the Alps, called Aletsch Glacier, about 23 kilometres long. Then once at Concordia Platz, you turn left next to the Concordia Hut, and you take the passage called Grindenwald, 3,273 metres. Then you go down and across another glacier, Wetterhorn, to finally arrive at the Finstaraarhorn foot. In total, more than 14 kilometres of hiking. From this point, the real ascent of the summit starts, more than 1,000 metres in height difference, over 4 kilometres. We wanted to tackle this climb before the heavy winter snowfall arrived. We were avidly following the weather forecast for 2 weeks, and when the conditions were favourable, we gathered our equipment and hit the road.
So we get up on the Jungfraujoch railway, and then we start from there.
We started from Grindenwald by the Eiger Express, which is the most modern cable car in the world, and this took us to the Eiger Glacier. Then we took the Jungfrau railway, which passes through the Eiger and Mönch mountains and serves top of Europe, 3,454 metres, the highest railway station in Europe. After more than 50 minutes, we arrived at the starting point of our adventure. The place is made for tourists with lots of exhibits, videos and experiences to enjoy. This is reflected in the high price of the ticket at €200 per person.
We go through the labyrinth of tunnels to find our way out to the outside. And there they go, the tour, up there. Snow fun. I don't know where we're going. Upside.
We decided to visit all these attractions on the way back. As usual, we had optimistic ideas.
Tour there. Alpine sensation tour.
After having passed several galleries and corridors, we are finally outside. The view is magnificent and the weather is on our side. Under the curious eyes of tourists, we put on our crampons and snow plaques and left the observation platform carefully prepared by the snow groomers, or better known in the UK as peace bashers.
You all right, Ka? You feel confident?
So here we are. We've just started our trip.
The top of Europe is here.
The top of Europe. Oh, you have another refuge over there. I don't know what is it.
Behind us, we noticed another refuge. We found out afterwards that in reality it was an old radio station that was part of a military complex. We noticed a few crevasses, but the path seems safe for now. The long descent begins. We advance on very hard snow.
How are you, Kat?
Following the clearly visible traces left the day before by other hikers. The view is amazing, the weather gorgeous, but the clouds are starting to roll in. I find it really hard to walk and film. I'm going to go down the crevasse. The sun and clouds give the snow-capped mountain landscape a very dramatic effect. The view is breathtaking.
We will go behind where it's like a refuge.
Like we're just going on never-ending expanse of a snowfield. It's just beautiful out here. At the moment, we're the only ones here.
Yeah.
The intrepid explorer continues across the glacier and tries to find, locate the path that we must take to get up to the mountain. After nearly 4 hours of walking, finally we arrived to the place called Concordia Platz. The Concordia Platz is a large flat area of snow and ice lying just to the south of the Jungfrau. It's part of a UNESCO World Heritage Site, vowing to retain the aesthetic beauty of the region. Its notable feature is that it is the junction of four large glaciers coming down from surrounding mountains. Needed some energy. To our left is the valley we need to take to reach the Grindenwald Pass. The route looks pretty okay.
My eyes went funny. And I couldn't see.
We just noticed the Concordia Hut, perched high on the rock like a fortress.
You are doing the trail.
I was pushing it like hard and it just didn't do anything. Story of my life.
How are you? How do you feel?
Okay, but
it was hard. Is a bit tired, huh?
From far away, the ascent didn't seem to be very steep, but once we arrived near to the pass, we found it was quite steep and tiring with the altitude. Each time we reached what we thought was the pass, we saw another hill in front of us to climb. It seemed like it was never ending. Finally, we reached the pass. The view was incredible. The sun was dancing with the clouds. It started to be late and we still needed to cross another glacier.
We're getting cold, the wind's whipped up, it's got quite icy.
Yeah, it's quarter to five.
So yeah,
we need to go here and it's not really sunny. How are you, Ka?
Hey!
It's easier now, no? To go down, huh?
Yeah. Now.
We started our fast descent on the north face of the pass. The snow was powdery and thick. The sun gradually disappeared behind the mountains and the luminosity decreased. It was difficult to see any details on the snow. Everything became white and uniform. In the distance, we catch sight of our home for the night, Finsteraarhorn Hut. We saw the first crevasses, but we didn't want to get linked up with the rope because we were in a hurry. The night was advancing too rapidly.
Oh, we are not far.
Suddenly, Bob fell into a crevasse. Luckily, it wasn't too wide or deep, and his backpack stopped him falling any further.
You all need to jump here. Jump from here, don't worry, here is hard, and here is hard.
From this moment onwards, our pace slowed right down because Bob needed to check every step with his sticks.
We are near. Wow. Good. It's not finished yet.
We can see the arrow. We will remove the crampons and climb to the refuge.
The last few meters to get to the hut were very difficult for me. I was so exhausted from the day. I didn't think that I'd make it up.
Well, a little less, for a start. I had my honour day, and I really didn't think I was going to make it up to here tonight because I was so exhausted. But my gorgeous fiancé, he took my backpack for me. So he was carrying two backpacks and the sticks. And I don't know how he carried both because they're pretty heavy. And I need to tweet more, really, because I didn't have a very good breakfast.
If I was not very old, we'll just stop and die.
Yeah.
Nah, you will be not very old.
That's for sure. No way would I be across the glacier on my own, spending the night in a little hut. It's quite cosy in here, though, actually, because it was really windy out. Bob wanted to sleep in the tent, but I said, no, I'm really tired. I just want to put my sleeping bag out. I don't want to sleep because I'm exhausted. I might feel different once I've had my pasta bolognese.
It's cold, huh?
Yeah.
Zero.
But yeah, it's pretty chilly out there as well. It was pretty windy and I think it's snowing now too.
Yeah, we've got all this snow. We had to get the surface snow off because it was a bit dirty. So hopefully this is all right. I'm sure we'll be fine.
Well, and we will start fire. We will leave lots of money.
Yeah, so we've got some logs there, so that's great. We're going to relax, I think. So Bob's going to make a fire because it is bloody freezing in here. And I think we're cold because we haven't eaten yet. So
we're on fire going now. So soon warm this place up and cut food. Got my pasta bolognese, which is the nicest one they do at the Capital. Tastiest, isn't it?
Maybe.
Oh, I haven't put two in yours or no?
Food?
Yeah.
So, Ka, it's our first night in
a refuge.
In a refuge together.
Yes, huh? My first night in a refuge ever. It's great.
So, yeah, but it's great because we are on our own.
Yeah.
So we have our chalet for us.
Yes, private room.
But it's okay. So good night and bye.
Till tomorrow.
Another day starts. See, we cannot see the summit, so I don't know where to go. So what I will do, I will try to walk a bit higher. How are you, Micah?
I'm all right, yeah. It's nice to be able to actually stand up and or sit down properly to have our food.
Yeah.
Early in the morning, I decided to attempt the summit. I was hoping that maybe the sky would clear up.
On tourne à gauche. Oh, la météo devient vraiment exécrable. Busy place.
so it's good to know. Voilà.
The higher I went, the stronger the wind blew, and the clouds became denser.
When Bob returned from his recce, the weather started to deteriorate rapidly. We decided to commence our return as quickly as possible, so we prepared our backpacks and left the hut.
Yesterday we arrived, it was already dark, so I didn't film, but yeah, see the traces.
The snow had started to fall and the sky was completely covered with low clouds. The visibility was decreasing every second, but we still didn't realise what would lie ahead of us.
Nice crevasse, but one is still open.
This time, for our safety, we decided to rope together. We were apprehensive crossing the glacier again after what happened yesterday, but we had no choice.
Follow my steps, or you need to jump, huh? Voila.
The weather became crazy, but this was only the beginning and we still had a long way to go. At one point, it was impossible to see anything.
So I hope that it's somewhere there. Well, we will see.
It was a complete whiteout. Fortunately, we were in a gorge and all we needed to do was to follow the slope.
As you can see, we cannot see anything.
Show how it goes.
I'm such a weakling, I can get my bottle open.
Voila. We have arrived to the pass. I still don't know the name, but the pass is just here. So we finished with the glacier, which is good. And now we go down to the next bivouac point.
Finally, we arrived at the pass, and now we could see further away. The most difficult part in the glacier with crevasses was over. We were feeling more confident. We decided to spend the night in the Concordia hut.
Voila, the worst weather passed. Now we can see something. And the refuge is just above here. So we go here and we turn left. So now we go to this refuge. It was not on our schedule, but as we couldn't climb the Finsteraarhorn, but we go here. Voila. Ah, ready, go?
And we just go there and after the ropes to get to these stairs. Oh, I just here. It's well fixed in the granite.
stairs to get to the hut went on forever.
Oh, putain, it's bloody long, this one.
What we can do here?
You can place the ladder.
And where we are? Oh, we are just like here. In the middle of nowhere.
The glasses.
Well, but you can post your letter. No problem. They pick it up at 2:15 p.m. Nice. Voila. We discovered a new city here in the mountains.
I've got Bob well trained, clearing the snow off so we can put our tent down. This is our place for tonight. Look at that, what a view. Room with a view.
So now we will prepare the tent for the night. So it's quite easy.
This night we weren't lucky. In fact, all doors were locked. This time we needed to put our tent up instead. Yeah, we found a nice little corner sheltered from the wind.
So simple. I thought we'd had the last of the snow, but it's starting again. Look at that, wow. So now we've just got to put the bottom bit down and quickly get the tent on top before it gets covered in snow. Because it's starting to stay harder now. And this will be perfect for tonight. Oh, yeah. Yes. We've had our food, we've had some coffee, so we're quite happy. And it's gone all cloudy again out there, so you can't really see much. There's Bob in the little snuggly tent. It's cold. Wow, look at that.
But voila, oh, it's time to wake up. Oh. How was the night?
Interrupted.
Oh, well, we have some snow everywhere. It's frozen a bit everything. We had some snow, like centimeter or two centimeters of snow. So it's time to make a coffee. So I have here some snow ready. And here is our table to cook. Melting. The snow is melting and now I put a bit more. Our sleeping place, our tent. Karen is still sleeping, of course. Well, for coffee. It's enough, so now I will cover. How was the night, Ka? Huh? No, but let me know. No?
Oh. I look like a scarecrow. What's the caravan?
Next to you, in the middle. One coffee. On va servir le café. Maintenant, service individuel. Je vous en prie, madame.
So, Carl, how is your breakfast? What we have?
My coffee was lovely.
For breakfast, and now it's a
now
kind
it's
of soup.
Vegetable soup, which I haven't started yet. It's too hot.
No, it's not hot, because it was already cold.
This is what makes us very happy.
It's special moments like this that make all the hard effort well and truly worth it.
Bob's taken all the ice and snow off the tent because it was snowed all through the night. On and off we kept hearing it. And we all iced up inside. It was wet and it was dripping on us. Yeah, it's just amazing. Look at that up there. So we've got to go today up there, around the corner, back to top of Europe. It's just wow. And the stillness and the silence here is incredible.
And this is why we like to be in the mountains. Aka, it's gorgeous, huh? It's incredible. So we are a bit lucky, even if we haven't perfect weather this time.
We're going that way. So hopefully it's going to stay like that for us.
Yeah, we will have a beautiful view. But the view is incredible.
Yeah. We're leaving our bivouac place and it was totally fine.
And now we have clouds back, but it was great. We had a beautiful view.
And now we go there. We take the stairs over there and go down, and after we cross the glacier and we go up, up, up.
These stairs are the consequence of global warming. In fact, 20 years ago, the glacier arrived much higher up the rock. You can see here the remains of the old path. Definitively, the stairs are not made for people with vertigo.
You can see some footprints of some creature, some animal that lives here, but we're not sure what it lives on, because there's just nothing to eat.
Yeah,
so
strange. More footprints, but I really don't know what they can eat here, because there is nothing. And here we have another mark, which is good.
Well, we're down from, hang on a minute, down from up there. I don't know if you can see the steps up there. We came down the steps, and then across rocks we had some cables to hold on to, thank goodness. Across the rocks there. It doesn't look very steep, but it is. There's no wind today. My hands have warmed up now at last. That's good. 2 days ago, we walked up there, and from here, it doesn't actually look that steep, but it is.
Yeah,
when you get there.
And it's a long way, yeah?
You think you've got to the pass, and then it continues, and you're going up still the other side. It's time now to put our crampons and our snow blacks on, because we've got over the rocks and now we're going to go over the glacier. Well, I'm ready to rock and roll. What are you playing at?
When we left this place, we were very optimistic about our return journey. But alas, the unexpected happened, as you will see.
It looks like it could turn out to be a lovely day when this cloud burns off, I think. Oh, it's just magnificent, just incredible.
So, we see the mark I left, so we are on the right place to cross this huge crevasse. But this way it should be like two glaciers. One is coming from here and one is coming from here. And it's like a collision.
Right, we're gonna climb up here. Maybe what, these are ice axes.
I keep you. Good. Bravo. We cannot really see the path, so we just go straight. But with the light like this, there is no contrast, so it's very difficult to find the path in the snow. We left it 2 days ago.
Well, a long way and cannot find footprints, so not easy.
Sun was just poking its head through the clouds. We're still not sure which way we're gonna go. Hopefully we'll see top of Europe. Then we get round the corner, then we'll know which way to go.
Because I don't remember if we go on the left or on the right. Allez, we go.
How it's going, Ka?
Yeah, good.
Are you sure?
I'm tired.
Under such conditions, our sense of direction is completely disturbed. As I was behind Bob, I was permanently checking that he was moving straight ahead in relation to his tracks. Otherwise, we were going in circles. Moreover, we had to stop every 20 steps to check the GPS that we were heading in the right direction. We were wondering if we'd have to spend another night on the glacier.
We are completely in the middle of nowhere. We cannot see anything. It's white everywhere. Fortunately, we have our GPS track.
Suddenly, the clouds parted and we could see the top of Europe. We were ecstatic. But it didn't last. The clouds were not on our side and came back even thicker. And to top it all off, Bob went down another crevasse, situated literally 50 meters from the path.
This one was bigger. Voila.
But that's not all, folks. When we arrived at the base of the top of Europe, we couldn't find the doors we left through 3 days beforehand. The landscape had been completely reshaped by the peace bashers. In fact, yesterday was the last day that the tourists could have access to the outside.
They has changed everything here we couldn't recognise, and the entrance was just there.
It was time for our adventure to finish. We were completely exhausted and were extremely happy when we located the door to the inside.
Yeah, it was like difficult to find the entrance.
Yeah.
Here ends our adventure. What we experienced was not what we had expected. Mountains are changeable and unpredictable. Our adventure is evidence of this. The 3 days we battled with the adverse weather conditions were very demanding, tiring and scary. But what we went through has strengthened our bonds and showed us that as humans, we can manage to adapt to any situation and circumstance. We couldn't believe our eyes when we saw how beautiful the weather was on the opposite side of the mountain.